Hello and welcome to my video. Today I will be taking a look at this MK-328 component tester. This is a really ubiquitous device that is widely available from eBay and AliExpress and other shopping websites in different variants. And I've been using this one for a couple of years, and today I will offer you my opinion about it. The device itself is pretty large. It is only a tiny bit smaller than my ancient scientific calculator. And it came with a set of test leads. And also with this thing that connects to the device. And it has a zip socket, which allows you to quickly insert and release the components. And when I first saw this component tester, I thought that it used regular banana plugs to connect test leads, but unfortunately they are so-called mini banana plugs. So here you can see a regular banana plug on the right and a mini banana plug is on the left. And it is quite a bit smaller than regular banana plugs. And unfortunately, the test leads have pretty low quality, so I already had to repair all of them. And this one I had to repair twice, because first the mini banana connector fell off, and then the test hook also fell off, so I had to solder them back. The zip socket is also pretty low quality. It's a fake, so it's not a genuine Textool zip socket. It says TFXT doll instead, so a Chinese copy basically. And unfortunately some of the contacts already do not close properly. The case of the tester is made of pretty sturdy plastic, with two exceptions. So the test button does not feel very good, but so far I have not had any problems with it. And the flip-out stand is also pretty junky. As you can see, it really flops around in the wind and does not do its job properly. But let's turn the device on and see how it performs. I will start by measuring some resistance. So this is a 1.33 kilo ohm 1% resistor. So it should measure somewhere between 1317 and 1343 ohms. So if we test it, we get 1,337 ohm, right on the money. Now let's move to capacitors. So I will start with this big one. 6,800 microfarad. 6,943 microfarad. Voltage loss is 1.9% and ESR 0.06 ohm. The next one is 220 microfarad at 200 volts. 217 microfarad, V loss 0.3% and ESR 0.14 ohms. The next one is this old Soviet film cap, 4.7 microfarads at 63 volts. 4.69 microfarad, V loss 0% and ESR 0.08 ohm. The next capacitor is 3300 picofarad or 3.3 nanofarad, and we get 3209 picofarad. Okay, and the final capacitor is just 27 picofarad. This is a silver mica capacitor, so let's check it. And we get 25 picofarad, quite believable. Also, when measuring capacitors in the picofarad range, it is really better to use those clip leads instead of this zip socket, because the parallel contacts in the socket actually add some stray capacitance, so your measurements will be quite a bit off. So let's check it. So as you can see, the zip socket adds 5 picofarad of stray capacitance to our measurement. Now let's move to semiconductors. Here I have some silicon diodes. Yep, so as you can see, it shows voltage drop and the capacitance of the PN junction. Now let's test a transistor. This is a 2N3904. And as you can see, it correctly detected the pinout, and it also shows that our DC current gain is 337. Finally, let's test it with a JFET. This is a Toshiba 2SK170. And as you can see, it shows the pinout. It shows that the source to drain current is 0.6 milliamps at gate voltage 0.42 volts. And it correctly detected that this is an N-channel JFET. Just from the measurements I've taken so far, this device seems to be pretty accurate. Let's also test its precision by taking repeated measurements of the same capacitor. So let's start. 3215. 3218. 3219. 3218. 3218. 3219. 3218. Basically, it seems to be pretty precise as well, because all the measurements are pretty close to each other. Now let's disassemble the device. First of all, it would be really interesting to see what is inside. And also, you have probably noticed that the screen is a bit crooked inside the case. So maybe I will be able to straighten it out when I open it. Now here is a nice surprise. As you can see, there are metal inserts in the case, and the screws basically go into the inserts and not into bare plastic. The PCB is pretty nice quality, so the heart of the device is this Atmega microcontroller, and here is the JTAG connector, so it should be possible to flash a different firmware. Unfortunately, as you can see, one of the battery cables was pinched when the device was assembled, but overall the quality is pretty okay. And here you can see the other side of the PCB. The test button is a proper push button and not some membrane bullshit. And unfortunately, I will not be able to straighten the screen because it is soldered to the PCB. As you can see, the device is back together, and what is my verdict? Well, as a component tester, it performs brilliantly, but all the mechanical aspects of the device are really quite shoddy. My guess is that the PCBs are produced in a factory, and the rest of the device is assembled manually using unskilled labor. That's why there is such a difference in quality between the main PCB and the rest of the device. But I must say that these testers are really, really cheap, and for the low price that you pay, you will probably not find anything better. So, recommended.